Consolidator. Today we're going to be playing some TEW2020. This time doing the Montreal Aftermath save. I converted it over from 2016. We are starting in December in week number one, building to Degeneration X in your house, which was one of the last few pay-per-views to actually carry in your house and monitors. So, yeah, let's get to it. In an abysmal pre-show match, Taki Michinoku defeated Brian Christopher at 751 with a Michinoku driver, got 53. Taco with a 52, Brian with a 44, the storyline advanced and gained heat. In a pre-show bout, they had a decent reaction from the crowd. So far, wrestling, Owen Hart defeated Savio Vega with a sharpshooter, got a 68, Owen with a 75. DX makes an entrance to start out a little bit raw. Had a promo on Shamrock. Shamrock taunts Ken, basically saying, Shamrock couldn't cut it in the UFC, that's why he's here. And soon after Sunday, he'll send Shamrock down south, just like he did his buddy Brett. And in a match that had decent reaction from the crowd, so far, wrestling for Vader defeated the Sultan when the Sultan was disqualified, when the artist formerly known as Goldust ran in and attacked Vader with a pipe. Rox has an interview with Michael Cole, ranting about Steve Austin, talking about how he's the greatest Intercontinental Champion of all time, how he's the real Intercontinental Champion, and Michael Cole reiterates that he has yet to beat Steve Austin for the title, that he merely just stole the title. Vince McMahon comes out, and we have the birth of Mr. McMahon, where he cuts the fabulous promo where he screwed Bret Hart. He said he'd screw Steve Austin, and the fans done it to themselves, and from now on, it's a new regime, new day, everything's going to be done his way, nothing's going to stop him, not even Steve Austin. And in a terrible match, LOD defeated the Godwins with Adam and Mario Godwin with a Doomsday device. And then the Outlaws attacked LOD after the match, shaved their heads, put them through the announce table just to set up the tag team title match. Steve Austin makes an entrance, and Austin cuts a promo on Rock, calls him out, wants his title back, says Rock may have his title, but Austin's the real champion. The Nation come out, Farouk trades words with Austin. It ends with D'Lo and Kama getting sent to the ring. They both take a stunner for their efforts. And about that terrible wrestling and no crowd heat, Shamrock defeated Perez with a submission with an ankle lock. Shamrock with a 77. Bill Watts could have done better as a road agent. Paul Bearer promo on Undertaker. Says Undertaker will be destroyed at the hands of Kane. Should Taker ever man up and fight his brother? And in a terrible match, Kane won a 3-on-1 match with Bob Holly, Flash Funk, and Bart Gunn. Kane defeated Holly with a chokeslam. And we get a segment where Triple H is walking backstage, getting ready to head to the ring, possibly to a promo or have a match, when all of a sudden he gets jumped by Owen Hart. Owen Hart has returned after his hiatus from the Montreal Screwjob, setting his sights on those that screwed his brother, and therefore is now looking to take out Triple H, and with the hopes of going after Shawn Michaels. And then we have an interview segment. JR interviews Taker, asking if he'll ever fight his brother. Taker says no, he made a promise to his parents that he would never, ever, ever fight his little brother. Ever. And our main event, Steve Austin defeated Farooq by pinfall with a Stone Cold Stunner. And then in a freestyle segment, Austin stuns the entire nation as Rock flees with the Intercontinental title. Austin celebrates with beer, and meanwhile, Farooq's just looking at Rocky stunned, like, what the hell are you doing? And then the show closes with Shamrock and Shawn Michaels in a backstage brawl as road agents and Triple H and everybody are trying to break it up, trying to pull them apart, but Shamrock's just incensed. And a post-show match, Undertaker defeated Shawn Michaels when Shawn was disqualified, when Triple H ran in and attacked the Undertaker. This was just to test the waters for that potential Royal Rumble casket match that I do plan on doing. So that will be the main event of the Royal Rumble. And we got an 81, which is pretty good. I enjoyed it. Don't have enough storylines going on. Yeah, because we're large, so we probably need 3 or 4. Probably 4 above 70 something, maybe? Go ahead and advance and see how we did against WCW. Hootude and Mortis. Okay. Whoa. They just turned Luger before Starcade. Okay. That's interesting. And they actually had Sting wrestle on Nitro. Sting and DDP defeated Luger and Eddie. They had Luger turn on the Giant. Okay. They did a 88, so they kicked our ass, and they got a 5.75, while we got 81 and 3.17. So naturally, they kicked our ass again, just like in real life. Well, hopefully after the pay-per-view we can come off strong and kick the living shit out of WCW. Let's see what else there is. Let's check the emails. WCW offering this for a contract. What are the offering? With Dancer. 49, Jesus Christ, y'all can have me. You ain't worth that damn much for me. Really? Got off $27,000 for... Fuck you. Fuck you, CMLL. I want Valdez. Terry Fox, Freelancer. Y'all really made an offer to that company. Really? Just to spite me? You fucking bastard. God, Bishop's a bastard. I knew this shit was coming right here. I knew that. Oh, what did they offer? Huh, he's turning down $109,000. Holy shit. What did they do? They're probably gonna sign a Warrior. Nope, he's considering not. The Warrior's turning down hella money. Wow. Okay. Well, definitely, some interesting things going on here. The next time you see me will be for Shotgun Saturday night. So, yeah, I will see you guys on the flip side.